people of music, the people of songs, who are not acquainted with sleep. They wander about in the wild lands with their musical gadgets hanging on their shoulders, and they're inquisitive about the weird destinations they never knew about before, and no one knows about those destinations. Ajaban namaze mastane to bigu durastastan. It's a very strange prayer of your mastana ashik. Tell me, is it true? Ajab namaze mastane to bigu durastastan ki na donad uzamani na shinasad uzamani. He's asking that there is a very strange prayer of your mastana ashik. Ashiki and mastana pana are directly proportional to each other. So there is a strange prayer of your mastana ashik. Tell me, is that correct? That when they pray, or when he prays, he forgets about the time and he forgets about the space. Ajab namaz mastane to bigudurastastan ki nadanad u zamani na shinasad u makani. Now coming to Sarasa, when the beloved is sagacious, is skillful, and see Latif's expectation. Mehrumai marivya mahirathi namua. They died unskilled. They could not die dexterous. They could not die wise. They could not die skillful. Mehrumai marivya mahirathi namua. Chidi jiyan chuhanjahani ladyaun loa. Hubabai hua unhiya wadiya vichame. And Latif gives examples of those who died deprived, who could not die skillful, who could not die wise. And he uses a simile of a sparrow, a simple, small, tiny bird, and says, like a sparrow, they came into the world, they picked a few grains into their beak from the heap, a big heap, and they ceased to exist. So those people came into the world. They could not know the mysteries of the world. They were like bubbles of water into the ocean. They ceased to exist. Mehrumai marivya mahirathi namua. And then what he expects from teachers, which are not commonplace teachers like us, he expects oryai aadin medio mualim khabrun. Oryai aadin medio mualim khabrun sata sudhnadin jit vah vedha kare. So he says the so-called teachers are mualimin. They go and bring information from the seashores, just from the seashores. They are the people of the seashores, since they do not enter into the deep waters. They do not know the stories of the midstreams, where careless gushes flow in the heart of the ocean. They don't know that story of the mid of the streams. Now coming to Sur Kalyan and Yaman Kalyan, a couplets from there. When the lover is in the pain, and he or she does, she of course, she doesn't want to invoke healer. Andha undha vej khal kujadya khaniye. Andha undha vej khal kujadya khaniye. Asa lukhi deela mein tu pyariye pej surya jani sej maran tini mushahido. Oh, you ignorant, you oblivious doctor. There is pain of love and you burn my skin. I'm already in physical anguish and you push me to drink the medicinal concoction. To me, the gibbets or gallows are like nuptial bed, where death is nothing but the union with the beloved. Asari Bolini. How can I forget Khusro here? Asari Bolini man barkhiz e nadan tabib. Asari Bolini man barkhiz e nadan tabib. Dardman de ishq ra daru bejuz di dar nist. Oh, unwise doctor or physician, get away from my pillow. Don't stand from my head. There's no therapy or remedy for those who are stricken by love. All they need is just the sight of the beloved. Ragu thiu rabab vajan vel sabke hain. Ragu thiu rabab vajan vel sabke hain. Luchan kuchan nathyo ja. Luchan kuchan nathyo janabariya jabab. Ma all veins tremble. Constantly in beloved's love, like a string of violin. Manchange to am, Rumi. Manchange to am, bar har rage man tu zakhm zani man tan tananam. I'm your violin, and you hit or strike in every kill of my vein and vibrate, and I vibrate, I pulsate. Ragun thiu rabab, vajan vel sab kahim, luchan kuchan nathyo. Janibariya jabab, soi sandhinam supri, kayas jain kabab, soi an azab, soi rahat ruhaji. I will read it again. Man change tuam, bar har rage man, tu zakhm zani, man tan tananam. The second last part, when the lover is a yogi, or ascetic, or a mystic, and the beloved is unknown. He talks about, Bhitai, Latif, talks about the 12 days of sohbat or company with the ascetics or yogis, most probably in Bhitai's own experience. He observed them for 12 days continuously, being with them. He was a very young boy at that time, Bhitai. He observed them that the yogis were wearing dust and cinders on their saffron color attire. They were with long hair and were never normal. They breathed in love. They were secretive, who secretly traveled from place to place, stayed at unknown abodes of pilgrimages, ate very little from begging, stayed humble with folded hands, stayed quiet. Khamoshi maini on daurat ki dar guftan nimi ayat. Silence is more meaningful than conversation, or what silence carries, words cannot carry, or conversation cannot carry. So they lit fire and sat beside the fire with blazing glow of having a vision of beloved. They know amazing and novel meanings of love, ishq, and also of fire. There is a captivating saffron glow on their faces. Love kindled ecstatic beauty into their eyes. They meditate and have been sleepless. And they have overwhelming commotion in their mind. They're consumed. Why commotion in their mind? Because they're consumed by fire of love. But never show that off. But I doesn't believe in showing that off. They have reveries of having sight of beloved, and they are nearing the marvelous union, and at last they united with the beloved. Deh dehai naah jit peer na pakhyaan. Deh dehai naah jit peer na pakhyaan. Tite khaudyaan varadai vana chundya. Jitna pakhi a peer tite timke bahiri. Jitna pakhi a peer tite timke bahiri. Biobari do keer khaud ki a kheerari hai. Dothi sa doreen ja jui sui na budhi. Pasa mathe pahane khaudi khodin. Vidya ut vodin jit nyahat nahaka. Hey, Latif talks about unknown lands where fire is set high at a place where even birds cannot reach. Now, who are they who have kindled the fire on no man's land, or people of uncommon territories? They launch their khimas at the inhospitable mountainous surroundings. They search for the spiritual knowledge in the boundless zone. And he says, Nuri and Nari. Now this is a woman again talking. Nuri and Nari, Jogira Jahaname, Bari Janbari, Auna Jiandi Unariya. Again, a woman defines characteristics of her traveling beloved. She mentions of the two types of nomadic ascetics in the world. There are Nuris, who have illuminating light of love inside. And there are Naris, who have illuminating fire of love inside. And then she says, how can she love without her Nuri and Nari beloved, who give light to the world by burning themselves, who burn themselves and give light to the world? Hence, burning is important, fire is important, secrecy is important in asceticism, in tasawwuf, meditation is important, and sometimes asceticism is also important, modesty is important, simplicity is necessary, traveling is indispensable, lighting is essential, and uniting with the beloved is important. In nutshell, ishq is indispensable. Now coming to the last part. Last but not the least, when the beloved is unity into diversity. Vahdatan kasrat thi kasrat vahdat kul. Vahdatan kasrat thi kasrat vahdat kul. Hakku hakiki hekru bia boliya ma bhul hu hula cho hul. Bila sajo sandho sajane. There's multiplicity, there's plurality which springs from the unity. Then Latif says both unity and plurality originate from infinity. And now whatever you name it God, you name it nature, you name it divinity, or call it something else coming out of something, or nothing coming out of nothingness, there is inexorable unity. The diversity is mere misleading, it's merely a speculation. Ek kasar dar lakh kode kans gidkhyun. Ek kasar dar lakh kode kans gidkhyun. Jidha karya parkh tera sahib samu. This cosmos is like a huge citadel, huge mansion with zillions of doors and windows. Wherever I glance, I have a vision of my beloved. Kode kayaun tunju likhan lakh hazar, jeev sabke hai jeesi darsan dharo dhar, prem tunja paar, keda chahi keda chama. Oh beloved, you have manifestations, innumerable forms of manifestations. Your spirit, your essence is present in every being, yet the images, acts and performance of being are not the same. They are unique. Oh love, how would I say your immeasurable attributes? Jam yek nurast, magar rang hoye mukhtalif. Jam yek nurast, magar rang hoye mukhtalif, ikhtilafi darmiyane in or on andokhte. The light and the whole is the same, but its shades and hues are different. He himself has caused variances between this and that. Now, two definitions of beloved that are very strange, that are very marvelous, and the first one is too mysterious, but I'm explaining. Aashiq macho unake, makhi cho maashuk. Aashiq macho unake, he's neither the lover nor the beloved. Aashiq macho unake, makhi cho maashuk, khalik cho ma khamatu, makhi cho makhluk, salj tahi sluk, jo naqisa ningyo. So, now this is the definition of love, one of the definitions of love of beloved that Bittai defines. Do not call him lover, nor the beloved, or you juvenile, you immature. Do not label him as the maker or the creator or the originator of this world. Neither he is a creature. What is he then? Is a mystery? What is the message of Bittai then here? So that is the only one can understand this mystery who are at the highest stages of consciousness, who are at highest stages of knowledge or even morals or even character. Paanai jal jalalahu, there's another definition. In the first definition, he says he's neither this nor that. In the second definition, he's saying opposite, that he's this and he's that and he's everything. Paanai jal jalalahu, paanai jaan jamal, paanai surat priyanji, paanai husn kamal, paanai peer murid the, paanai paan khayal, sab saboi hal, manjhai maloom the. Again, a new definition of beloved. Previously he said he's neither this nor that. Now he says he's this and he's that and he's everything. The beloved possesses. He's majestic. He himself is beauty. He's the guide. He's the follower. Everyone's contemplation would give evidence that all is nothing but his manifestation. Murghishi. Murghishi, sidhishi, damghish. Sadr khishi, farsh khishi, bam khish. Yourself are the bird, you are the prey, you are the trap, you are the snare. Yourself are the seat, you are the ground, you are the balcony. I'll conclude with Bittai's poem, but before Bittai, I would read something from Diwane Kabir. Yare mara, ghare mara. Yare mara, ghare mara, ishq jigar khare mara. Yar toi, ghar toi, khwaje nigadar toi. Qatr toi, behr toi. Lutf toi, qahr toi. You are the drop, you are the ocean, you are the blessing, you are the curse. Qatr toi, behr toi, lutf toi, qahr toi. Qand toi, zehr toi, bishma yazar mara. You are the sweet, you are the poison, don't give me this much pain. Hujra-e khurshid toi, khona-e nohid toi. You are the place of sun, you are the place of bright star. Roza-e umid toi, yard-e rahmara. You are the tomb of hope. Oh beloved, show me the path. Dawn-e toi, dawn toi, you are the prey, you are the trap. Baud-e toi, jam toi, you are the wine, you are the bowl. Pukht-e toi, kham toi, kham be maguzar mara. You are the complete, you are the incomplete, and don't let me pass incomplete. So he, so who, so ajal, so Allah, so pri, so pasah, so veri, so vahru. Finally, I will end with this thought that he says he's this, he's that, he's the destroyer. He's the creator, he's the beloved, and also he's the breath of life, he's the adversary, and at the same time, he's a leader, he's a mentor. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for that, Ms. Goel. I think all of us can agree that the words creative intensity were very rightly focused. For that, the next segment is a translation of the poetry of Shah Latif, and it will be presented by Ms. Noorul Huda Shah. She's a renowned dramatist and a writer of Sindh who writes both in Sindhi and Urdu. This transcreation is in free verse and is her own, and it aims to capture the beauty of his words and message in a language that we also know very well. So if I could please invite Ms. Noorul Huda Shah on stage.
پہلی اردو میں تھوڑا گالان چاہیں دس یہ ایک ہمارا خواب تھا میرا انیس کا فہمیدہ کا کہ ہم کراچی کے سٹیج پر شاہ لطیف کو اردو اور انگریزی میں لے آئیں مہتاب سے آپ نے سنا سحر سے آپ نے سنا کہ شاہ لطیف سرحدوں میں بند شاعر نہیں ہیں ان کی زبان ان کا انداز بیان ان کی سوچ اس کی اڑان بہت وسیع ہے یہ ہماری بدنصیبی ہے یا یہ ہمارا چھوٹا پن ہے ہمارے ذہن کا چھوٹا پن ہے کہ ہم اس اڑان کو اس طرح سے پکڑ نہیں پائے میں نے کوشش کی ہے میں آج کل اس پر کام کر رہی ہوں شاہ لطیف کو آج کی نسل کے سامنے اردو میں اس طرح سے لے آؤں کہ اسے کوئی ریفرنس ڈھونڈنا نہ پڑے وہ شاہ کی سوچ کو اس کی گہرائیوں کو اس کی اڑان کو محسوس کرے دیکھے پکڑے کھیلے اور شاہ کو اپنے اندر سمیٹنے کا اعزاز حاصل کرے شاہ کا پہلا بیت شاہ جو رسالوں میں جو ہے اول اللہ علیم اعلیٰ عالم جو دھنی قادر پہنجے قدرت سے قائم آ قدیم والی واحد وحدہ رازق رب رحیم سو سارا سچو دھنی چئے حمد حکیم کرے پان کریم جوڑوں جوڑ جہان جو تو ہی اول تو ہی اول تو ہی اعلیٰ تو ہی علیم و مالک زمین و آسمان ازل و تا ابد تیرا وجود تیرا کمال تو والی تو واحد تو وحدہ تو رازق تو رب تو رحیم تو ہی ثناء ذات ہے خود اپنے وجود کا تو ہی وہ کریم تو ہی وہ کریم جو مصور خالق تخلیق دو جہاں وحدہ لا شریک لہو جنتو سے ایمان تن منیو محمد کارنی قلب سان لسان او فائق میں فرمان اوتڑ کہن اولیا او فائق میں فرمان اوتڑ کہن اولیا کر اقرار وفا اور کہہ وحدہ لا شریک لہو کر اقرار دل کہ ہے محمد کے کارن یہ کائنات و رنگ و بو حکم بندگی و سر تسلیم خم یہی ہے رہ مستقیم پہ ہم اوتڑ کہن اولیا ستڑ ویاس سالم ہیک آئی ہیک تھیا عہد سیں عالم بے بہا بالم آگے کیا اگئیں سیاہ گھٹا و گھاٹ سے گزرتے ہیں اشاک سبھی عشق سبات میں جو جذب ہوئے اور ایک ہوئے وہی چنے دلدار نے وہی دل ربا ہوئے آگے کیا آگئیں نسوروئی نور لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون سچن کونے سور مولا کیو مامور انگ ازل میں ان جو روشن روز ازل سے ہے جمال رخ یار عشق یار میں اتر اور گزر بے خوف و خطر وعدہ ازل ہے لا خوف علیہم ولا ہم یحزنون آ مجھ سے عشق کر اور مجھ ہی میں اتر یہ عشق بھی امر ہے یہ یار بھی امر. پتنگ چاہیں پان کے تچی آگ اجھائے پچن گھڑا پچایا تو پچن کے پچائے واقف تھی وسائے آگ نہ دیجے آم کے پتنگا کہے ہے تو خود کو پتنگا کہے ہے تو خود کو یہ آگ کیا شے ہے تو آتش عشق میں اتر تپش عشق سے جل جل کئی راکھ ہوئے تو آتش عشق بن کر دکھا تو آتش عشق میں اتر تپش عشق سے جل جل کئی راکھ ہوئے تو آتش عشق بن کر دکھا راکھ ہو چکی راکھ کو پھر سے جلا مگر راکھ ہی میں راز بن اور آگ من میں دبا زمانے سے چھپا یہ جلنے بجھنے کی کتھا. رگوں تھیوں رباب وجن ویل سب کے لچھڑ کچھڑ نہ تھیو جانبرے جواب سوئی سندھین دیم سپری کیس جہیں کباب سوئی این عذاب سوئی راحت روح جو رگے دل ہوئی سازے رباب رگے دل ہوئی سازے رباب بجا کی روز و شب تیرا سکوت بے پناہ میرا بے زباں اضطراب تو ہی گوندے مجھے پھر سے تو ہی بکھیرے بار بار این یہی میرا عذاب جاں ہے این یہی میرا قرار دل بیتاب. جے تتو تن تنور جیاں تچھنڈے سان چمار آنے آگ دب جی بارے جان جلائے برکان اندر بازیوں پہنجو سب پچائے لچھن لون لطیف چے پدھر حد مپائے متاں لوک لکھائے وسالاں وچ پے گرچ گر جلتا ہے تن تنور مثل گر جلتا ہے تن تنور مثل دو بوند سے بجھا پھر اٹھا شولائے عشق اور جلا کے جان جلا وجود چلمن کر اور چھپ کے لو بن دھواں سا جو اٹھے کہے لطیف اسے بھی چھپا سنبھل لمحہ وصل تماشا دنیا نہ بنا سنبھل سنبھل لمحہ وصل تماشا دنیا نہ بنا سنبھل دیدار و نگاہ یار کے بیچ زمانہ نہ ہو حائل وحدت جے وڈیا اللہ سے اورین